Hello everyone. In this first part on the cranial nerves, I will introduce you to the various cranial nerves and their functions. In the learning objectives at the end of this session, you should be able to enumerate the 12 pairs of cranial nerves with their numbers, to classify them as sensory, motor, or mixed, to know their attachment to the surface of the brain, to know their openings or passages through the various foramina in the skull, and to understand their different functional components. So there are 12 pairs of cranial nerves, which are designated by Roman numerals from 1 to 12, and these numbers are designated according to their attachment on the surface of the brain from front to behind. The first cranial nerve is the olfactory nerve. The second is the optic nerve, third is the oculomotor nerve, fourth is the trochlear nerve, fifth is the trigeminal nerve, sixth is the abducens nerve, seventh is facial nerve, eighth is vestibulocochlear nerve or stereoacoustic nerve, ninth is glossopharyngeal nerve, tenth is vagus nerve, 11th is accessory nerve, which has two parts, cranial root and a spinal root, and the 12th is hypoglossal nerve. In this column, we can see that the cranial nerve can either be sensory, motor, or mixed nerve. The pure sensory nerves are olfactory, optic, and vestibulocochlear, whereas pure motor nerves are oculomotor, trochlear, abducens, accessory, and hypoglossal nerves. Whereas the mixed nerves are trigeminal, facial, glossopharyngeal and vagus, means that these nerves carry both motor as well as sensory fibers. This is the inferior view or the ventral view or the base of the brain in which we can see the attachments of the 12 pairs of cranial nerves from front to behind. Out of these, the first two cranial nerves, that is olfactory and the optic, are related to forebrain, whereas the remaining 10 are related to the brainstem. So this is the first cranial nerve. Here, about 15 to 20 filaments of olfactory nerve terminate in the olfactory bulb. This is the olfactory bulb from which begin the olfactory tract. And the olfactory tract will divide into lateral and medial olfactory stria. This is the second or optic nerve, the second cranial nerve. This is the optic chiasma and this is the optic tract. This is the oculomotor nerve. This is the trochlear nerve. The oculomotor and trochlear nerves are related to midbrain. This is the thickest cranial nerve, which is the trigeminal nerve, having a small motor root medially and the large sensory root laterally. The trigeminal nerve is related to the pons. This is the pons. Now at the junction of the pons and medulla, this is the pontomedullary junction, we see the sixth cranial nerve, this is the abducens nerve, lateral to which this is the facial nerve, and lateral to which is the vestibulocochlear nerve. So these three cranial nerves, 6, 7 and 8, emerge at the pontomedullary junction. From the surface of medulla oblongata, we can see here, this is the glossopharyngeal nerve, below which vagus nerve, and then the cranial part of accessory nerve emerge. Whereas the spinal part of accessory nerve arises from the upper 5 to 6 cervical segments of the spinal cord and joined with the cranial part and forms the accessory nerve. These are the various foramen or opening in the skull which transmit the various cranial nerves. The olfactory nerve passes through the olfactory foramina present in the cribriform plate of ethmoid. The optic nerve passes through optic canal or foramen. The oculomotor, trochlear and abducens nerve pass through superior orbital fissure. The three divisions of ophthalmic nerve, that is frontal nerve, lacrimal nerve and nasociliary nerve, pass through superior orbital fissure. The maxillary nerve passes through foramen rotundum, whereas mandibular nerve passes through foramen ovale. These three nerves, that is ophthalmic, maxillary and mandibular, are the three divisions of trigeminal nerve. The facial nerve enters the ear via internal acoustic meatus, whereas it leaves the facial canal of the middle ear via stylomastoid foramen. The vestibulocochlear nerve also passes through internal acoustic or auditory meatus. The glossopharyngeal, vagus and accessory nerves pass via jugular foramen, whereas the hypoglossal nerve pass via the hypoglossal canal. The spinal part of accessory nerve enters the posterior cranial fossa via foramen magnum. So here in this diagram we can see the interior of the cranial cavity, showing the various foramina through which the cranial nerve pass. This is the cribriform plate of ethmoid bone showing olfactory foramen, which gives passage to about 15 to 20 filaments of olfactory nerve. This is the optic canal through which the optic nerve passes. This is the superior orbital fissure through which oculomotor, trochlear, abducens and the three divisions of the ophthalmic nerve pass. Here is the foramen rotundum through which maxillary nerve will pass, behind which is the foramen ovale through which mandibular nerve will pass. This is the internal acoustic meatus through which facial and vestibulocochlear nerve will enter the ear. This is the jugular foramen through which glossopharyngeal, vagus and accessory nerve pass out. And this is the foramen magnum through which spinal accessory nerve, as we can see here, the spinal accessory nerve entering the foramen magnum and joining the cranial part. This is the hypoglossal canal through which the hypoglossal nerve pass. Now, to understand the various functional components of cranial nerves, we must know that cranial nerve can carry either sensory fibers or motor fibers. Sensory is also known as afferent and motor is also known as efferent. Cranial nerve can be purely sensory or purely motor or may be mixed, having both the fibers. One cranial nerve may have one functional component or more than one functional component. Now, coming to the sensory or afferent fibers, there are three types of sensory or afferent fibers that a cranial nerve may contain. The first is the somatic sensory or general sensory fibers. These are the sensations of touch, pain, temperature, pressure from the skin, or proprioceptive sensations like sensation of position of a joint or state of contraction of muscle. So such type of sensation that is of somatic origin. So these are known as the general sensory or somatic sensory fibers. Second type of fibers are visceral sensory fibers, which carry general sensation from viscera. These sensations are mainly the sensation of distension, stretching or pain sensation or reflex sensation from various viscera, glands and blood vessels. It also includes the sensation of ischemia if there is decreased blood supply to the various organs. The third type of sensation is a spatial sensation. So the fibers which carry the spatial sensation, they are spatial sensory fibers, which include hearing, balance or equilibrium, vision, olfaction, that is smell, and the sensation of taste. So these are the spatial sensory fibers. So there are three types of sensory fibers: general sensory from the skin or from the joints or muscles. Then there are general sensation from the viscera, and there are spatial sensations. Coming to the motor fibers that cranial nerve may carry, there are three types of motor fibers. First is the somatic motor. Somatic motor fibers supply skeletal muscles, that is striated muscles, related to the limbs and body wall, but do not develop from the pharyngeal or branchial arches. So these fibers mainly supply the muscles of the upper limb, lower limb and the body wall. So such type of fibers are known as somatic fibers. Whereas other type of fibers, they are known as branchial motor. Branchial motor fibers supply skeletal muscles derived from pharyngeal arches or branchial arches. For example, muscles of facial expression, muscles of mastication, muscles of soft palate, muscles of pharynx, muscles of larynx. And these are present in the head and neck region. So the cranial nerve which supply these muscles, they are known as branchial motor. In relation to this, we must remember that muscles of tongue and the muscles of eyeball, they do not develop from pharyngeal or branchial arches. These muscles develop from cranial myotomes. So the fibers supplying these muscles, they are somatic motor and not branchial motor. Coming to the last functional component, and that is the visceral motor or secretomotor. This forms cranial outflow of parasympathetic system. So these fibers are actually carrying preganglionic parasympathetic fibers, and they will supply various smooth muscles, glands, and the cardiac muscle. These fibers will relay in a ganglion, which is a parasympathetic ganglion, from which postganglionic fibers emerge and supply the various glands, smooth muscle, or cardiac muscle. So these are various functional components of cranial nerves, and in my subsequent lectures, I will tell you about the functional components of individual cranial nerves. Thank you.